This instructional video will help you learn and master each movement before advancing to the follow-along version. Pause and rewind often, and move on only when you feel confident. Hello, welcome to Primal 7's Hip Series. I'm Jenna Ellis, physical therapist for Primal 7. This series is all about the hip and how we can improve its motion, strength, and everyday movements that it's involved with. The hip joint connects our legs to our pelvis and our torso. It's designed to carry a lot of our body weight, making it a very stable joint. It's a ball and socket joint, and therefore it can move forward, backwards, side to side, and also rotate. This means the hip is working when we sit down to a chair, lunge, pick something up off the floor, step side to side, or twist the leg. We use the hip during Primal 7 squats, lunges, hip hinges, and balance and walking activities. The hip can be hurt in many different ways, one of which is when we don't stretch out the muscles properly. Tight muscles can result from exercise, such as running or cycling, but also from sitting at a desk throughout our day for long periods of time. When the muscles get tight, it can result in painful conditions such as bursitis and tendonitis. By stretching out our hamstrings and hip flexors, we put our body in a better position to move through full range of motion during not only exercise, but our daily lives as well. Another possible way the hip can be injured is by weak gluteal muscles, also known as your butt muscles. The outside glute muscle's job is to keep our hips level when standing on it. If they're weak, they can cause the hip to drop down out of alignment when you walk. This causes increased stress and strain at the hip and other joints down your leg. It can also cause you to walk with what looks like a limp. The exercises in this series will help strengthen these muscles and keep your hips level and also promote proper walking mechanics. Our goal in this series is to stretch out the tight muscles surrounding the hip and to strengthen the weak ones, so you can move through a full, pain-free range of motion. If you've looked at our knee series, you may notice that some of the exercises are the same. That's because the muscles can start at the hip and end at the knee, thus affecting both joints. If there's a weakness or a tightness, it will throw off your alignment, not only at the hip, but also your knee, your ankle, and your foot as well. Join us as we start moving in this hip series to get yourself out of pain and into a new lifestyle of healthy movement. Let's get started.